Vancouver, the city of Burnaby is in court Friday in its effort to evict a group of protesters who have been camping across from Kinder Morgan's Burnaby Mountain property on the side of a city-owned road. Camp Clough protesters, opposed to the planned Trans Mountain pipeline expansion, refused to leave when the city issued a notice of eviction last month. The city argued the camp had become unsafe and that protesters should be welcome on the site but not allowed to camp there. Camp Cloud at the corner of Shelmont Street and Underhill Avenue in North Burnaby. No one representing Camp Cloud appeared to be in court Friday morning, although some of its supporters were there to observe the proceedings. Jennifer Godier, for Star Metro, now the city is requesting a court order that would allow them to take down the camp structures with or without the group's cooperation. Greg McDade, the lawyer representing the city of Burnaby, said the city is sympathetic to the aims of these protesters and has taken an official stance against the expansion of the Trans Mountain pipeline. But the structures the occupants have erected, including a two-story building meant to serve as a carver's cabin, and a fire maintained on site, really have nothing to do with the protest and pose a major safety hazard. The camp is located in a wooded area near industrial tanks containing flammable liquids. Article continued. Below, no one representing Camp Cloud appeared in court Friday morning, although some of its supporters were there to observe the proceedings. Read more. BC Grand Chief urges action to prevent catastrophic climate chaos as costs of Trans Mountain Pipeline risk a cost to Twin Trans Mountain and Pipeline $1.9 billion higher than expected. Kinder Morgan documents should show WBC. Supreme Court judge sends Reverend, former pastor to jail over Trans Mountain protests. Indigenous leaders at the heart of the Camp Cloud protest have argued that forcing the campers to leave would violate their charter rights. Quetzal Tattle, a member of the Stow-Low Nation, previously told Star Metro that camping at the location and having a ceremonial fire there was a practice of their sacred and ceremonial ways. Article continued. Below, McDade argued Friday that Tattle and the other Camp Cloud occupants wouldn't be able to successfully argue their rights to the land. He said only nations themselves have successfully made such claims in case law. It shows an attempt to claim this public location as their own property, McDade said in his arguments. McDade referred to the camp as having been expropriated by the occupants, which drew scoffs from the supporters of Camp Cloud in attendance, who support Tattle's assertion that it's located on unceded territory. Justice Jeffrey B. Gomery, who was appointed to the B.C. Supreme Court in June, said Friday that he was very troubled by the fire located at Camp Cloud, especially because the weather in the Lower Mainland has been dry for the last month. Kyle Friesen, lawyer for the Royal Canadian Mounted Police, was also present at the hearing. He told the court that police were concerned about Camp Cloud becoming more of a public safety issue as people online have threatened vigilante action to clean up the camp. Murray was expected to give a decision Friday at 3:30 p.m. Alex McKean is a Vancouver-based reporter covering wealth and work. Follow her on Twitter, @alex_mckean.